This week on American Airgunner, we travel to Tempe, Arizona for the 2013 Shoot Right Airgun Expo. We'll review the Samyang Sumatra, Steve Criner's with us, and I have my first challenger of the season in our new segment we call Rossi Versus. All this and more coming up right now. All right, we're here in beautiful Tempe, Arizona at the Shoot Right 2013 Air Gun Expo. We're gonna go inside, shoot some guns, meet some people, and see what this expo is all about.
The expo this weekend, we want to help others be able to promote the product or guns that they may have. Some of them might be used, some guy that might be a private collector, just want to show off his collection. We have a unique type of guns that people can appreciate for ethically taking game to just target shooting. A lot of the expos have a lot more selling, like vendors or something like that, tables. We're really geared towards the shooting program. Our primary focus is basically educating our community and our nation about basically properly how to use guns safely in a manner, but doing it in a different way that's more affordable through the air gun.
So I'm here with Kim Grady, who's the vice president here at Shoot Rights. And Kim, how you doing today?
Great.
Yeah, you feeling good?
Great weather, yeah. Great.
The weather's incredible. So tell me a little bit about what you do here at Shoot Rights.
Well, as vice president, I do a lot of PR, you know, working with the people and raising awareness about guns and air gun training in particular. And I also do a ladies course. I got into the airsoft and air gun training for ladies a couple years ago when I and my husband recognized that we kind of needed a kinder, softer way to get women eased into going on the range.
The beginning stages start with air guns. Why?
It's the kinder, softer thing, but if you notice with my gun, this is my airsoft training gun right here, It's actually a replica of a Kimber 1911 that I carry myself, a 45 cal. Mm-hmm. So you can teach everything. You can teach the parts of a gun with these guns. You can teach, this is a actually the action actually works. You can actually work the slide back, the safety. Everything is exactly the same as the gun that I carry for self-defense.
What would you say the biggest benefit of starting with air guns and then going to firearms, as opposed to the women who you just put a firearm in their hand for the first time? What's the biggest difference?
Safety is a big one, but I think the other thing too is a really good comfort level. Because one of the biggest questions I get from women is, I'm afraid of how I'm going to look if I go into range. And it's not how they're dressed, It's how they look. It's how they look when they touch a gun, how they look when they handle a gun, how they look when they shoot. If a girl, I'll pose for, a girl is standing there shooting like this, the guys see this sticking out and they automatically know she's a beginner.
Yeah.
You know, and they come
Let
up
Let me
and
help her.
Exactly.
Sure. If you're comfortable with something, it's a lot easier. So do you see a complete transformation if they've gone through the airsoft course first, then when they get an actual gun in their hand, how much they're that much more confident?
Absolutely. I've seen it in myself. I had a hard time keeping both eyes open. And since I've been going through my training and doing it with the just practice, I've trained the muscles in my eye so that I have immediate focus and immediate alignment. I almost don't have to use my sights anymore.
So you've learned how to do it now because it's obviously less intimidating with the air gun. How to do it with both eyes open.
Just simple little mechanics like that throw you off shooting and make you not shoot as good.
Well, thank you so much. It's very nice to meet you. Okay. I love you've got the gun earrings and the gun necklace and you're carrying your... I love this girl. It's time for a little three-gun competition. So you can see they're getting set up behind me, but I'm gonna run through the course, test my skills, see what I got. All right, so in today's three-gun competition, it's gonna be pretty fun because we're using three different guns, three different stations, and a whole lot of targets, which I love. So first of all, we're gonna be using an AR-15 clone, which is the MAR 177. Awesome gun, really heavy, same weight as an AR-15, and I've got 9 targets to knock down, but only 10 shots. All right, so then I'm gonna move to the next station where I'm gonna be using the Beretta PX4 pistol. 8 shots, 6 targets, all varying distances. So then I'll be moving to the third and final station. Since we don't have a shotgun, we're gonna be using the Beretta CX4 Storm, which has 30 shots, but there's only 6 targets. So I'm gonna go through all 3 stations as fast as I can and try to do the best I can in this 3-gun challenge. Wish me luck. Here we go. Beep.
Beep.
There you go. And I got to tell you, it's the first time I've ever done that. And I only missed one, so my time's got to be pretty good. All right, Robson, what was my time?
59 seconds.
59 seconds, yes. Less than a minute. That was our goal. And I couldn't have done it without Rob because he told me exactly how to move through this course precisely and safely, and it worked. I missed one target, but I went back and got it. So it's about as good as I can do, let's be honest. This is cool. This was a three-gun competition. It's kind of our demonstration. It's one of the many challenges and competitions here at Shoot Right where you can go and learn how to do these competitions. So you guys find a local place where you can go and shoot and learn to compete so you can go be a competitive airgun shooter. Rob, thanks, man. I appreciate it.
Good job.
Good time. Thank you very much.
American Airgunner is sponsored by Umarex, zeroed in. Pyrmayd Air, America's largest retailer of air guns. And by Hotsign, serious, solid impact.
The pistols you've watched in action for generations and the ones you've always wanted to own are now within your reach. Introducing Umarex Action Pistols. These high-quality replica pistols, powered by CO2, look, shoot, and feel just like a powder burner. Plus, ammo is economical and always available. Umarex Action Pistols. From the past, present, and shooting into the future.
The Umarex Octane features tremendous velocity with a quiet downrange noise thanks to the integrated Silence Air Noise Dampening System. Powered by the Reaxis gas piston that provides more punch, more power, and more speed. These two technologies combined deliver a smooth, accurate shot with maximum power. The Umarex Octane.
PyrmayDair.com. Let's see.
That was fast.
Bingo.
Honey, did you do those chores yet?
Chores?
Roger, put that drink down. We gotta mow. Chop, chop.
Oh, yeah. He's out there showing the grass he's boss.
Pyrmayd Air. Big selection, fast shipping, the air gun experts.
All right, it's time for our American Air Gunner Trivia, brought to you this year by our friends at Blue Book Publications. You know, being the host of American Air Gunner, everybody thinks they can shoot better than me, so I'm constantly being challenged from people across the country, and I can't take all the challenges, but sometimes they just keep on and on and on, and I have to take the challenge. Meet my competitor. Say hi to Naomi.
Hi.
So she has challenged me to a shoot-off with the Umarex Steel Force. Now, Naomi, have you shot this gun?
Yes, sir.
Do you shoot a lot of guns?
Normally.
You do?
Yeah.
Okay, so why this gun? Why'd you challenge me in this gun?
I did it. Daddy did, actually.
Oh, Daddy. Well, you might recognize her dad as Rick Eutsler, our resident gun critic. So, Naomi, tell me, are we going to be just taking turns and trading spaces to using the same gun?
No.
No? Why not? Oh, you have your own gun, I see.
Mm-hmm.
Well, somebody's serious.
Okay, so Naomi, I see there's two targets there. Which target's mine?
The pink one.
Of course it is. Huh. Any last words before our competition?
No.
Is that your mean face? That's the cutest face I've ever seen. What happened to your tooth? Somebody shoot it out?
No, I lost it.
We've got 30 BBs. And it's just whoever can hit the bullseye the most?
I think so.
Okay, are you ready?
Yep.
I'm gonna let you say go. I notice you have a laser pointer at your target there.
Ready, set, go.
You
You going full auto on me?
Yes.
What's happening over there? I gotta get into this. All right, I think I've been hustled. Naomi, look at you. You're like a deadeye.
I'm pretty impressed.
Let's do that again.
You want to do that again?
Yes, sir.
All right, one more round. All right, here we go. Last round. Do I still have the pink target?
Yes.
Why?
Because you like pink.
I do? Okay. You say go.
Ready, set, go.
All right, so there you go. Who do you think wins?
Me.
Why? Really?
Because I'm six.
Because you're six? My very first shoot-off with one of my challengers. I'm going to say Naomi wins. Congratulations.
Don't go anywhere, because coming up next, Rick Eutsler will be taking a look at the Samyang Sumatra. We'll be right back.
Quiet Energy, a new line of PCP air guns from Hatsun USA. Available in 177, 22, and 25 calibers. The Quiet Energy line of air guns is perfect for serious target practice as well as small to medium-sized game hunting. The new Quiet Energy series delivers more usable shots per fill and puts more energy down range while keeping the noise levels to minimum. If you're looking for power and accuracy in a quiet air gun, your search is over with the Quiet Energy line of PCP air guns from Hatsun USA.
Life can be loud, but sometimes silence is golden. Introducing the Umarex Fusion Air Rifle with a combination of CO2 power, the Silence Air 5 chamber noise dampener, and a precision rifled barrel. The Fusion is a bona fide tech driver that's the quietest air rifle you'll ever own. Experience silence with the Umarex Fusion at umarexusa.com/FusionTV.
It's time for a gun review. We've got Rick Eutsler here, our resident gun critic, and today it looks like we're going over a Samyang Sumatra 22 caliber.
Absolutely. You're dead on the money, my friend.
I am very familiar with the Samyangs. I love them. They're comfortable. They look like the old Rifleman rifles. You know, I love the fact that you can cock them. But tell me what we got here. This is a little different. I've never actually seen the 22.
This rifle, I've just done my first full review of this gun, and what I learned is that I don't know that I'll ever be done with this gun.
Okay.
Because this thing is unbelievably versatile. It's got a six-shot magazine, mm-hmm. And what's very cool about this is that this magazine, let's pop it right out here, okay? It's got a lot of space in there. You can see right through there. That means you're gonna be able to put really long pellets in this magazine. Unlike some others that maybe will limit you on the size of the pellet you can use.
Uh-huh.
So this can use everything from the real short, small ones all the way up to the really long engines that are super, super heavy.
Okay.
Now the way you make use of that versatility, and on the bottom of the gun here, you got a power wheel.
Okay.
So you can turn that all the way down, or you can turn that all the way up.
Okay.
And the difference, let's say we're taking like an 18 grain JSB. Mm-hmm. On low power, you're gonna get probably 60 shots, shooting at about 750 feet per second.
At the lowest?
At the lowest, okay. You crank that all the way up to the highest setting, and that goes to almost 1,300 feet per second.
Really?
I mean, just smoking fast.
Wow.
And it drops down to like maybe 15 shots. So yeah. You use a lot more air when you're cranking it.
Sure.
But you can get a lot more power. What that means is you would really not want to shoot those at that fast. But if you get a heavier pellet, like a 20-some grain or a 30-some grain 22, they make some really heavy 22 caliber pellets.
Sure.
This gun can crank over 50 foot-pounds.
Okay, so you can adjust to pellet, for velocity, for what you're hunting, for what you're shooting.
You completely versatile.
This gun can be basically fit for any situation you may be in.
It's like the Swiss Army knife of air guns. I mean, it is. It can really, it has a, like I said, incredibly versatile magazine. The other thing it's got, which is very, very cool, it's a little heavy, so you just have to know that going into it.
Right.
It's got a huge air reservoir. It's a dual chamber 500cc air reservoir, which gives it all that versatility.
Okay.
Very, very cool.
It's what I'm noticing, obviously. Not a whole lot of difference in visually from that, from the 50 caliber Dragon Claw or the Recluse. I mean, so all these guns are kind of similar in the fact that once you get comfortable with one of them, you can move up or down and it kind of goes the same, right?
Like the big difference with those is that they have a slide open breech and they're single shot. This, you can actually just work this action, and as you do, it rotates the magazine for you.
And the lever action is just sexy.
It's very cool.
It really
is. Some absolutely beautiful metalwork, some great woodwork. It's a phenomenally good looking rifle.
Anything else that we need to be aware of before we take it for a spin?
No, let's go shoot it. Grab that tank, would you?
Okay. Yeah, of course.
Now, what I'm going to have you do is go ahead and load this magazine up while I fill the gun with my inventory little pony bottle here.
Okay. Where's the...
Here's the magazine.
Yep.
Now, let's make sure we go in the right direction here.
That's the right direction.
Yes, it's going to go like that. Now, don't tip it backwards because they'll have a tendency to want to come out on you, okay?
Okay.
Let's see.
As you're filling it up, Rick, the tips on shooting this gun, because obviously we've shot a lot of 22s, you've reviewed a lot, some are quiet, some are, this is one of those ones.
This one is loud.
It's loud. It gives you that feeling for the guys out there that aren't sure about air guns, like, I really want to know that I'm shooting a gun, I like the loud, the feel. This is the gun for that if you want a 22 with some noise.
This gun is very loud. What I like to do is go ahead and tip the gun up like that.
Sure.
And that way when you load it in.
Yeah, much easier.
It goes in a lot easier, there you go.
Put our one on top.
And then go ahead and close it.
Okay.
And there you are.
All right, good to go. Anything I need to be aware of that I may not be?
No, aim for that little green dot. Yours should be all set.
green dot it is. See, I love the cocking mechanism. I love this gun. Here's why. And you tell me, and I could be crazy.
Okay.
Like to know when I'm shooting air guns that I'm shooting a gun. I love the noise. It's got a little bit of a kick, a little bit of a draw. I love this exchange. It just feels very old Western to me, man, I love
very
it.
Very nice gun. It has, because you have the lever action, if you're hunting small game,
yeah,
you have like an immediate follow-up shot. You're
sure.
Not having to cock a bolt. You're not having to do anything else. It's just dead on the money. It's really, really nice.
You know, if you're a shooter, especially I feel like for the guys who are kind of the natural rifle guys, the old hunters
that love
the black powder and stuff, this is a gun for you, man. These things are great. They shoot great. They're very accurate and a lot of fun to take out.
Absolutely.
Anything else you would recommend about it?
Just buy one.
All right, guys, for more information on the Sam Yang Sumatra, go to AmericanAirGunner.com. We'll send you, of course, to links to Airgun Web so you can find all the stuff Rick has to say about all the great guns out here. We got a lot more American Airgunner coming up next. Stay with us.
Absolutely.
All right, guys, after the break, we'll be joined by none other than Steve Criner. He's in Kansas, and his Umarex Octane is targeting some squirrels. We'll be right back.
A legend in innovation and tradition. These classical and modern masterpieces have sent pellets downrange for over three decades. German engineered to last a lifetime. Quality, power, precision. RWS, the world's finest air rifles.
All right, guys, today it's time to talk a little optics, and today we're talking how to keep your scope lenses clean. It's very important. People have problems with it all the time. Now, you want to make sure these are clean at all times. So when you're not using your gun, make sure you have some sort of lens cap or dust cover here that you have on the end of your scope, whether it be the kind that flip up like this that you kind of keep on all the time, or just the type you put on right before you put in your gun case. These are great to keep dust from accumulating on your scopes. Also, once it's out and you've used it and it's gotten dusty because you've been outside, there's a couple easy ways to do it. One of my favorites, canned air. These just kind of shake up. You want to blow the side, make sure it's not blowing any liquid, and then just helps you blow off the big pieces. Nice little burst of air on both sides will help you clean that, no problem. You could also go to one of my favorites, which is a dust brush. These are nice and simple and small. You just pop the brush out, there you go, you can clean it nice and easy. You can get this or canned air at your local sporting goods store or gun shop. Also, you know, things that you use to clean glasses or any type of computer screen or something, some of these things you get at camera stores, these little lens cloths, the kind of lens cleaners that come look like little moist towelettes, and even something like this, like a microfiber cloth. This stuff is great. You just, you know, little circular motions, you can wipe off any dust, any fingerprints, and then, you know, you keep this clean and it'll always keep your lenses clean. Now, after that, I recommend that you actually cleaning your lens covers here, your dust caps, just to make sure that no dust has gotten inside and you're now trapping inside your lens. So, you know, clean that out or blow it off, whatever makes sense, and then just pop it back on and you're good to go. If you have a scope that has turret covers, you want to take these off, blow them out, wipe them out, make sure you keep those clean so no dust or water or anything has gotten in there that might mess up your scope. You know, that's pretty much it as far as I'm concerned. The one thing I want to make sure you don't do is spit on it, lick it, blow on it, use your shirt, or lick your thumb like your mom does to fix your hair. That is not going to keep your scope clean, all right? If you want any other tips, go to AmericanAirGunner.com.
Hey everybody, I'm Steve Criner, the dog soldier, and welcome to this week's American Air Gunner. We've been out calling coyotes, it got warm, the coyotes ain't coming to the call, so I'm going squirrel hunting. Come along with me. Right here. You see where the tree goes up? Let me tell you what I like about this Octane. For one, it's accurate. It has technology that keeps it quiet. Gets you an air rifle that's quiet, accurate. If we get lucky, we'll shoot a mess and we'll have some squirrel for dinner tonight. Oh, there he is right there. Okay, that was a good shot. Whew. Hey, listen, we cleaned two squirrels this morning. We got one laying up yonder that you watched a while ago, and now we got this one. That's one away from a limit. If we don't see you with the fifth one, we'll catch you next time on American Air Gunner. Until next time, I'll see you on the road.
Next week on American Air Gunner, we'll be in my hometown of Fort Smith, Arkansas, hanging out with the Northside Grizzly High School shooting team. And of course, we'll be sitting down at the round table to talk about the importance of velocity with air guns. We'll see you next week.